And there's a real renaissance in Manchester at the moment for queer clubbing, I think. There's lots going on.
It's places like Body Horror where you really feel an energy that isn't necessarily as easy to tap into in mainstream spaces.
I definitely think with the arrival of the White Hotel, it's made a huge impact on the way we curate our parties.
Downtown Manchester is kind of finished as a place, really. This is the beginning of a movement now, which is going to go to the Twilight areas of Manchester, you know, the Shadowlands, and that's where all the magic's going to happen.
I moved to Manchester in January 1998. I didn't really understand identity and identity politics then. I had no knowledge of queer politics or history or anything really at that point. But for me, it felt like the kind of pillars of my identity were, one, I'm Northern and I'm really proud of that. Two, undeniably I'm queer. And three, and more importantly, and much bigger than either of those two things, I'm a music fan and I need to go where the good music is. Older lesbians around me started telling me stories about the protests that they went on, the marches and the demos. And then they started telling me about Section 28 in 1988, like the last piece of anti-gay legislation in this country. They educated me about James Anderton, the chief constable of Manchester, who was rampantly homophobic. And I started realising what an incredible fight had been fought.
When the Clause 28 march happened, seeing that many gay people on the streets did change things up quite a lot. And the people that organised it, they went around all the gay clubs, they stood on chairs in gay pubs and said, this march is happening, we want you to come.
We are 12% of the people on this earth and 12% of the children will be lesbians and gays. Who the hell's going to get a closet big enough for all of us?
Because we'd worked together in that struggle, that fed into the clubs a lot. So gay men and lesbians were going out together much more and they wanted spaces that they were in to reflect that. Hundreds and thousands of people trying to get into gay clubs, which is what happened with Flesh. You know, we literally had to put on the tickets, thank you for not being heterosexual. Heterosexuals will not be admitted. There was loads of women there that I just never clapped eyes on before, which is weird on such a small scene. You know, you get used to seeing the same faces. We had an ice cream van in the Hacienda and the fire brigade came in to just do a check on us. And then they got really annoyed that we've got an ice cream van full of petrol in the middle of the dance floor in the Hacienda. It was obviously like, and everyone was smoking in the club. And they didn't tell us to get it out of the club. They just said, could we push it towards the fire exits? Keep it in a rammed club of 1,500 people, but just put it towards the exit and that'll be all right then.
This must have been a piece promoting the first ever Homo Electric here. It states how open they are on the door. Mm. If you're homo, hetero, don't know, or lesbo, you're welcome, which was very different to the Flesh door policy.
It was basically a place for all misfits that loved music and loved partying in a really solid way. And that was more important than who you slept with.
Be ugly
was there, and in fact there's badges slogan. And everything that just say be ugly. I think they still use that actually as a slogan. Tennis. And that's where the beauty is, isn't it, in choosing to be ugly and not giving a toss.